Family, it's time to pray. And in our evening time, we've got one central focus that we want to arrest our attention and bridle our hearts and minds as we go to God in prayer. Don't stop praying. And on this evening, I want to look at Genesis chapter 4, verse 26, give you a brief thought, and then we can go to God in prayer. There's a clause at the end of verse 26 that I want you to grab a hold of. Genesis 4, verse 26, the text says, to Seth, to him also a son was born, and he called his name Enosh. Then men began to call upon the name of the Lord. Look at that clause again. Then men began to call upon the name of the Lord. The reason why that text is so important, such an imperative thought in our study and in our focus, is because that's the first time you read in a very matter-of-fact way in the biblical record that men began to call on the name of the Lord in prayer. That's what that phrase is actually talking about. It's not just a declaration that God or El is Jehovah, but people began to call on the name of the Lord. Interestingly enough, it is right after the great historical record of the fall of mankind, Genesis chapter 3. And shortly after that fall, you see the perpetuation of evil beginning to take place. Cain killing Abel. And then you're going to find on the other side of this genealogy listing, Genesis 4 is written, Seth is born. The genealogy begins chapter 5. And then right after that, chapter 6, you find that that's the narrative of the flood. Right after the flood, the calling of Abraham, and then the seed line narrative, the back and forth narrative of God working out his amazing plan from Genesis 3:15 all the way to the coming of Christ. And we read at the end of Revelation is unfolding. And in the middle of that unfolding, you find this one phrase, then men began to call on the name of the Lord. What are you saying, Thomas? I'm saying that the power of prayer in conjunction to the providential underpinning of God and the work of God is first seen right here in this book of beginnings in Genesis 4:26, which ought to drive you and I to see. The prayer is a pivotal part of continuing and being a part of the concert of God's hand and God's movement, not only in the history of the book, but also in the actual reality of your life. So the reason why you can't stop praying, don't stop praying, is because prayer is very much a part of everything that God has done for the scheme of redemption, and it's a part of how God is going to get you and keep you stable even right now. I want to give you three things very quickly. Number one, don't stop praying because prayer is seen in the historical response of God to the human condition. We see, I've already given it to you, we see that God responds to human hurts, the sin problem, by way of prayer. God will respond to human harm, Cain killing Abel, through prayer. And God will respond to human hopelessness, the ongoing bout of thinking that the enemy, Satan and his minions, are winning, only to know that God is always up to something, so we keep praying. Do you see this? You pray then. Every time we fail God, that's human hurt. Anytime you mess up like Eve and Adam, like Adam and Eve, like Cain and Abel, Abel and Cain, all of the failures of human condition, whenever we mess up, we go to God in prayer. Why? Because God knows you're hurt. He knows your inconsistency. He knows that you can't make it. He knows that you're frail. He knows that you're broken. He knows that you and I are able or susceptible to being deceived. He knows that we will openly shake our fist in his face and rebel. He knows that. So we go to him in prayer, asking him to bless us to make it through the human condition. But we also need to go to God when we deal with hurt. There will be occasion, and our season is one in which we see human hurt taking place, whether it be the pandemic or whether it be systemic racism. Whenever one life takes the life of another individual, or whenever we lose a life, human hurt is a reality that can only be navigated by the power of prayer and letting God usher you through some sense of hope. And we know then that God is the answer. He gives us the reason why we have hope, because he continues to move his agenda all the way through. God will get glory in any season that we're in. So we keep praying. We don't stop praying. Don't stop praying, because God has shown us that he will historically respond to any situation we're in the human condition. Did you catch that? He will historically respond to any situation that we're in the human condition. But then let me give you number two. Don't stop praying, because prayer is a holy reconnection to heavenly comfort. I love the fact that in the text, we know that God has already anticipated struggle. Genesis 3, he already knew that we would mess up. He already knew before he ever made the world, before he ever made mankind, he knew that that was going to happen, which is why Genesis 3:15, please go back and read Genesis, why Genesis 3:15 is so important. God anticipates the struggle, and God, number two, is already moving. I love later on in history, we'll get commentary from Isaiah, who lets us know that before we even ask the prayer, God is already answering the prayer. Isaiah 65 and verse 24. God is already answering, already moving to meet you where you are. So number one, he anticipates the struggle. Number two, he's already moving. Number three, he always supplies exactly what you need. You remember? But in the Genesis narrative, in the context of our verse, you'll find that Cain killed Abel, and there was a little bit of despondency. Why? There was despondency because God had just said in Genesis 3:15 that your seed will crush Satan. Well, here Cain kills Abel. Abel was the promised seed. Cain kills the seed. Satan moved through Cain to kill Abel, thinking that he would destroy the plan of God. But what he didn't remember, or what he didn't anticipate, is that God would raise up Seth to take the place of Abel, and the seed line will keep on going. Know something about your God. God is always supplying exactly what you need. Philippians 4:19 reminds you of that. My God shall supply all of what I need. So you can know that God is always responding, always moving, always anticipating your struggle. And number four, God answers those who call on him. The reason why I pray, the reason why you pray, is because it's a holy reconnection to a heavenly comfort that comes from a God who is the answer and answers humanity. Did you catch that? God answers and he is the answer. God answers and he is the answer. Stop looking for your answer to be in somebody else or something else. Stop looking for a solution to your problem, a solution for your pain, an ease for your issue. Stop looking everywhere else to find some sort of peace. God is your peace. God is your answer. God is your solution. Call on the one who can help you in your time of trouble. But listen, don't stop praying. Don't stop praying. Why? Because we see that God is the historical, he historically has always responded to the human condition. We see number two, the reason why I don't stop praying is because we find that prayer is a holy reconnection to heavenly comfort. But then number three, and I'm landing, don't stop praying, because prayer is the healing relationship we have to all of our hurts. Which hurt? The sin problem. God answers that. The struggle from just trusting him day by day, God answers that. Go back and read Genesis. And when you read Genesis, you'll find from Genesis chapter 12 that you're not alone. You're not alone in you trusting God and having problems with that. You're not alone with wondering whether or not this is actually how God's going to answer a prayer. You're not alone. What you'll find is you'll see person after person dealing with the same struggle, the same tension of wondering, God, is this how you're going to answer my prayer? Go back and ask Sister Eve whether or not God is going to answer the prayer this way. And he'll let you know, I got a Seth waiting for you. You just continue to have faith. Go back and ask Noah, how in the world are you going to deliver me and all this stuff? And I ain't ever seen something called rain. Go back and ask Abraham and Sarah, when God makes a promise, will he deliver it? I know it might take 25 years, might take a whole generation later, but God will answer the prayer. You go back and see that God has always given an answer to the sin problem. God will be with you in the struggle. What struggle? My struggle of faith, my struggle to remain focused, my struggle to stay fixated on God, my issue when I'm afraid, my issue when I'm giving up, when I'm fickle, when I'm rebellious. Know this about your God. He's not tapped out on you yet. And even when you go through betrayal and you go through what seems to be sabotage, what you may not see is that God is weaving your life together. He's patching you up, making you better, putting you in a new position, giving you new opportunity, allowing you new struggle, allowing you a new curriculum of life. He's allowing you to learn some things that you will need. You didn't know it when your brothers threw you in the pit. You didn't know it when you was in prison. You didn't know it when you was running from Sister Potiphar. You didn't know it until you got to a place where now all of your gifts can be used to be a blessing, even to the people who whispered, betrayed, and plotted behind your back. You can look them in the face and say, you meant it for evil, but God, God meant it for good. You don't know. But do know this, that in your struggle, God is healing every part of who you are so that you can become who he's called you to be. He's the solution. He's the healing solution for sin. He's the healing solution for our struggle. He is the solution to all of our issues. So we ought not ever give up on prayer. In fact, look at the text with me one more time. Then men began to call on the name of the Lord. Let me give you a challenge. When you struggle, when you sin, when you need a solution, then call. Whenever you struggle, whenever you sin, when you need a solution, then call. That's what this text is teaching us. In the book of beginnings, when you have your moment, then call. When you're going through what you're going through, then call. When you're living, then call. When you wake up, then call. Whenever you live and go through whatever you go through, then call. In other words, this text teaches us at the beginning of entire record of God, don't stop praying. When you go through what you go through, then call on the name of the Lord. Whenever you deal with what you deal with, then call on the name of the Lord. In other words, don't stop praying. Prayer is the historical response from God to the human condition. Prayer is where we see the holy reconnection of God's people to get heavenly comfort. Prayer is an opportunity to see the heavenly relationship of God to all of our hurts, our sin hurts, our struggles, and he is, in fact, the solution to all of our issues. Let's talk to him right now. Father, we love you. We thank you and we bless you and magnify you for being our God. We praise you for all of what you've done. We praise you, oh God, for the way that you continue to demonstrate your power in our life. God, we ask that you bless us. We pray, Father God, that you be with us even right now as we continue to deal with all of the hurts that we have, as we continue to matriculate through life and deal with the issues that are in front of us. God, I ask that you bless us and help us to see that you have historically always been the one to respond to us in everything that we've dealt with, in our sin, in our struggle, in our issues. Lord God, you've always been present. We love you. We love the fact that your track record is immaculate. We love the fact that you've always been the one who's providentially moving in our way, powerfully moving in our life, and always anticipating that we would need you and being there regardless of our own faith struggles, our own issues, our own inability to remain focused and diligent and faithful to you. Lord, thank you for healing us. Thank you for delivering us. God, we call on you and ask for you to forgive us. We repent of our broken areas. We repent of our sinfulness, and we need you, Lord, to tabernacle and take up a room in our life. Forgive us for those areas, Lord God, where we even right now are wrestling to act as if they did not happen. Forgive us for that. Defeat our spirits when they are in the way of you renovating our entire life. We want to think like you, act like you, behave like you, live like you, and we ask, oh God, that you help us to do just that. We ask even now, while we go through this season that we don't want to be in, that you do all of what you do, heal and deliver, strengthen and renew. Take up residence, Father, so we can see your power brand new and alive in our life and in our heart. We ask that you give those that need it strength and wisdom and power to overcome. We ask that you bless us, Lord God, to be your people in this season, to offer hope to those that are seeking after you. We ask that you get glory out of every breath we take and everything that we need to do for you and for your name. We love you, we honor you, we praise, and we bless you. And we ask that you use us up doing good and call us home when you're done. Keep us in the palm of your hand, Father. Help us to fail less and to fail to a point, Lord God, where we don't fail anymore and we walk like Jesus on this planet. We ask that you strengthen us. We ask, oh God, that you use us for your name's sake and for your glory. Be with us even now as we together say amen and amen. Listen, don't stop praying. Remember what prayer is for you and remember what prayer can do for the world. When you face sin, when you face struggle, when you need a solution, then call on the name of the Lord. Don't ever stop praying. Listen, I'm going to pray for you. I'm asking you, please, pray for me and let's watch our God change everything around us. God bless you and God keep you.
When I'm busy, or when I have things to do, Lord, maybe at a time when I don't feel well, when I'm down and feeling blue, Lord, but then I realize that I must submit to the call you place on my